Yes, ashimwe dushimye Imana uyu munsi kubwo umwanya mwiza idupaye kubwo amateraniro meza turi ku mbuga nkoranyambaga amateraniro araba mu buryo buri online ushobora kudukurikira kuri YouTube channel The New Life in Jesus Ministries ukore subscribe ndetse kandi nakazogera kugira ngo uzajye ubona notification wadukurikira kandi kuri Facebook yacu New Life in Jesus ukande like kugira ngo ujye ubasha kubona ubutumwa bwiza uko bugezweho turashima Imana ku bw'iki cyumweru cyiza Imana yaduhaye icyumweru cy'umugisha uyu ni umunsi Imana yaturemeye kugira ngo tubashe kunezererwamo reka rero dutangiye amateraniro yacu dusenga twiragize Imana ku bw'ibyo ibashije kudukorera Uwiteka mwami Imana ishobora byose tuguha icyubahiro kandi tukagushimye tugushimiye ibihe nk'ibi ngibi tugushimiye kuri Imana itangaje nta na kimwe kigutungura mu buzima bwacu uratuzi kandi uradusobanukiwe n'uyu munsi rero buri wese uri kutureba hariho hose turakwinyize kugira ngo ukore ku mitima yacu kandi uvugane natwe ibyo dukora byose tuze kuba tuyobowe nawe mu izina rya Yesu Kristo amen reka rero duhere kuri praise and worship team twakire itsinda ryo kuramya no guhimbaza Imana guhimbaza Imana turamya Imana hanyuma nyuma yaho turaze kumva ijambo ry'Imana karibu praise and worship team
zamuri amashimwe mpamba kuri kwiye tugiye kuramya izina ryawe mwami mwiza kuko nanjye wasa nawe urahebuje kandi uri ijuru ryose mwami wacu turaramya izina ryawe ryiza turaramya izina ryawe rihambaye niwe ukwiriye gushima mwami wacu w'igitangaza niwe ukwiye guhabwa icyubahiro niwe ukwiye gushyirwa ijuru ryose kuko nanjye wasa nawe imitima yacu igandukiye mwami mwana gucishwa bufi ngo turamye izina ryawe tuguhimbaze mwami we kuri uwo kwizerwa kandi nawe nduhanye nawe mwami wacu niwe ukwiye gushyirwa hejuru ibihe byose urakwiriye gushyirwa hejuru kuko niwe n'ibitangaza ukora ibikomeye umunsi ku wundi mwami nawe ntidufite uwo kwirata uretse wowe n'iryo zina tubone n'amagakiza iryo zina dushima iryo zina duhimbaza muri byose kuko ariryo zina tuboneramo gucungurwa mwami wacu urakwiriye gushima urakwiriye guhimbazwa urakwiriye amashimwe urakwiriye icyubahiro urakwiriye gushyirwa hejuru muri byose mwami wacu mwiza haleluya nawe duhasa nawe haleluya urahebuje mwami w'abantu ni wowe wera ni wowe ukiranuka reka tuzi ubwiza bw'urukundo muri byose mwami turashimiye neza urukundo rwawe kuko uri ukwizerwa muri byose mwami niyo mpamvu duciye bugufi kandi tugahubike kugira ngo turamye izina ryawe Mami Yesu Haleluya Umutima wanjye wagukiye kukuramya mukiza soko ibyiza n'ibyigikundiro n'ibishima byose ndagandutse namanutse nciye bugufi
Yeah. As we honor you, Holy,
you are
glory.
Hallelujah.
We want to welcome you this morning.
Tubahaye ikaze iki gitondo.
A great day the Lord has made.
Umunsi mwiza Imana yaturemeye.
It's a day we can thank God together.
Ni umunsi dushimira Imana twese hamwe.
And that today the Lord will speak to you.
Kandi uyu munsi Imana iravugana namwe.
And you'll be blessed.
Kandi murahabwa umugisha.
I would wonder we pray for the word of God.
Ndashaka ko dusengera ijambo ry'Imana.
And then from there the Lord will speak to us.
Hanyuma nyuma yaho Imana aza kuvugana natwe.
There is a word for all of us.
Hari ijambo rya buri wese muri twe.
And this word will minister upon your life.
Kandi iri jambo riraza kuvuga ku buzima bwawe.
Because the word of God is powerful.
Kuko ijambo ry'Imana ni iby'imbaraga.
It is able to accomplish the plan of God.
Ibasha gukora umugambi w'Imana.
And that is what is going to happen today.
Kandi ibyo nibyo bigiye kubaho uyu munsi.
Close your eyes, we pray together.
Kumeza,
Father, we want to thank you.
Data turashaka kugushima.
You are the King who is highly exalted.
Uri umwami ushyizwe hejuru cyane.
We thank you for this particular moment you are giving to us.
Turagushimiye kubw'uyu mwanya uduhaye.
We honor you.
Turakubashye.
Because you are God who reigns.
Kubera ko uri Imana iyobora.
I pray Jehovah God for the one today.
Ndasenga Yehova Mana
nsengera. Let your word accomplish your purpose.
Ngo ijambo ryawe risohoze umugambi wawe.
And let there be no interference of the enemy.
Kandi ntihabe kirogo yera yose y'umwanzi.
And minister to your people.
Uvugane n'abantu bawe.
In your own way.
Mu nzira zawe.
We thank you, everlasting King.
Turagushimye mwami uhoraho.
For you are the Lord.
Kuko uri umwami.
Even in this place.
Ndetse na hano.
In Jesus' name.
Mu izina rya Yesu.
Amen.
Amina.
Amen. Today I want to minister to you.
Uyu munsi ndashaka kubabwiriza.
And as we minister to you, the Lord will be taking over in your life.
Kandi bivuga Imana aza kuba iri gufata kuyobora mu buzima.
There is a message I want to share.
Hari ubutumwa nshaka gusangira nawe.
And we believe that the Lord will take over in your life as we minister this message.
Kandi nizeye ko Imana igiye gukora ku buzima bwanyu tusangira ubutumwa.
I want to touch on something that we need to give God the responsibility.
Ndashaka kuvuga ku kintu cyuko tugomba guha inshingano zose Imana.
Let the Lord take responsibility.
Reka ibyari ibyacu byose Imana ari bifata mu maboko.
We and some few days we are talking about let God arise.
Mu minsi yashize twari tuvuga ngo reka Imana ihaguruke.
And let his enemies be scattered.
Hanyuma abanzi bayo bose batatane.
And we saw the scattering of the enemies is the end result.
Twabonye ko abanzi batatanye byose biba birangiye.
It is a product.
Ni umusaruro.
It is what happens
nibyo bibaho
when God arises.
Iyo Imana ihagurutse.
So when God arises,
rero Imana ihagurutse,
what will happen?
Ibibaho,
there will be an effect to the enemies.
Abanzi bahita bahura n'ingorane.
Because they will be scattered.
Kubera ko habaho gutata.
But now I want to see us letting the Lord take responsibility.
Ubu noneho tugiye gufata inshingano zose tuzihima.
In another simple term, it's let God be responsible.
Mu yandi magambo ni ukuvuga ngo reka Imana ariyo iba nyinshi.
Our God is dependable upon God.
Imana yacu ni Imana yo kwishingikira.
He is a God you can depend on. You can trust in God.
Ni Imana wakwishingikirizaho, ni Imana wakwizera.
He is a responsible God.
Ni Imana ibishoboye.
And that's why we are looking today at Him taking the responsibility.
Niyo mpamvu uyu munsi tujye kwiha inshingano zose.
Now when we talk about God being responsible.
Yero tuvuze ngo Imana ifata inshingano zose.
God taking responsibility.
Cyangwa se Imana tugiye kwiha inshingano.
We are talking about that you have a relationship with God.
Tuba tuvuga yuko wowe ufitanye isano n'Imana.
And you know you can't depend on relationship of God which God has with another person.
Kandi ntago wagirana isano n'Imana utazi yo Mana yari.
I mean don't take someone else relationship with God.
Nuzafate isano Imana itanye n'umuntu wari wese wigiriye.
Each one of us, you and me included,
wowe nanjye ubwanjye,
you can only depend on your relationship with your God.
Icyakubeshaho ni isano ufitanye n'Imana.
I can depend on the relationship with my God.
Icyambeshaho ni isano ufitanye n'Imana
yanjye. So don't always be depending on other people's relationship with their God.
Rero ntuzishingikirize ku isano y'abandi bantu bafitanye n'Imana
zawe. And so that's what we are looking at. Let God be the one to be given the responsibility. God, I don't want to depend on me. I want to depend on you. I want to be so much related with you. Because the more I'm related with you, the more you are coming in so that you are responsible. So that you can take over the responsibility. Such that when I have issues, I don't look at me. I don't rely on me. I don't trust in me. I trust in you because you are God. So mine is to relate with you. Having a relationship so close within God, such that when things happen, you are sure of. God is the one to take the responsibility. You start a life of dealing with God. Even when the enemy comes, you don't see the enemy as a problem to you. Because you know God is the one you have related with. So he is the one to handle your enemies. And so, when God has taken the responsibility, it's a confirmation that in me, whatever it is happening, I am assured of one thing. God is in the mix. That God is in the midst of what is happening, such that I don't try to help me. I have a relationship. I wish somebody can understand what I'm trying to drive to. Before God becoming responsible, it's like if I can use an illustration. If you have a car, or if you have any other kind of a, you know, any other kind of a ownership, you know, or you anything else. If I have a car, before putting my car on the road, the very first thing is to go to the insurance company, because I want to transfer the liability in case there will be a problem. You insurance company, you are the one who is responsible. And so I talk to the insurance company and I tell them, this is the value of my car. Now look at the value of your relationship with God. It is very important to know how far, how much, how deep you are related with God. God will take responsibility depending on the relationship. How deep is the relationship? So when I go to the insurance company, they ask me, what is the value? I'll give them the value of the car. And from the value of the car, they'll be able to calculate the premium I'm supposed to pay. Likewise, God will be responsible in accordance to how deep you relate with Him. And today I want to say this: make your relationship with God to be so deep, such that even if there be a problem, you know very well I am related with God. I have a connection with God. So God will take over. So when you insure your car, or when you insure any of your property, you are saying, you insurance company, in case there is a problem, you have to come in. I don't have to fight it. Mine is to relate with you. Now you are the one who will come in so that you can compensate, so that you can be able to cover me. Now when you relate with God, you know one thing: I have an insurance. I am covered. I am shielded. I am protected. God is the one to take over in the event there is a problem. So when we talk about this relationship, we are talking about you transferring all your cares, all your burdens, all your issues to God, and you tell God, because I'm relating with you, you are the one who can come in the event things are not in the right way. And there is a scripture I want to read. In the book, let's turn to the Bible in the book of Psalms. Psalms 124. Psalms 124 from verse 1. The Bible says,
Biblia iravuga ngo,
if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, let Israel now say.
Yaba uiteka tariwe wari mu ruhande rwacu abari kwa Israeli bavuga none.
If it had not been the Lord who was on our side when men rose up against us.
Yaba uiteka tariwe wari mu ruhande rwacu ubwo ababisha baduhagurukiraga.
Then they would have swallowed us alive when their wrath was kindled against us.
Then the waters would
have overwhelmed us. The stream would have gone over our soul.
Amazi aba yaraturengeye rwose, isuri iba yaratembye ku bugingo bwacu.
Then the soaring waters would have gone over our soul.
Amazi yihindurije aba yaratembye ku bugingo bwacu.
Blessed be the Lord who has not given us as a prey to their teeth.
Uiteka ahimbazwe utadutanze kuba nk'umuhigo w'amenyo yabo.
Our soul has escaped as a bird from the snare of the forest. The snare is broken and we have escaped.
Ubugingo bwacu bukize nk'uko inyoni iva mu kigoyi cy'abagoyi, ikigoyi kiracitse natwe tuvamo turakira.
Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth.
Gutabarwa kwacu kubonerwa mu izina ry'Uwiteka waremye ijuru n'isi.
If it had not been the Lord,
yaba atari Uwiteka,
who was on our side,
wari mu ruhande rwacu.
It is a very strong statement here.
Hano ni ijambo rikomeye cyane.
From the word of God,
riri mu ijambo ry'Imana.
That if it had not been the Lord who was on our side,
yaba atari Uwiteka uri mu ruhande rwawe,
having God on your side,
kugira Uwiteka mu ruhande rwawe.
The writer of the Psalms is saying, if the Lord is not the one who was on our side,
wanditse Zaburi aravuga ngo iyo Uwiteka ataba mu ruhande rwacu.
So first of all, he is acknowledging,
icyambere arabanza akamenya,
that the Lord
yuko
is the one
Uwiteka
who was on their side,
wari mu ruhande rwacu.
And he says, when men rose up against us, so there are men who rose up, men who rise up against you, against me. But there is this verse that says, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side.
Ariko hari uyu murongo uvuga ngo iyo Uwiteka ataba mu ruhande rwacu.
Men rising against you.
Abantu guhaguruka basha kukurwanya.
It is not so much of anything.
Ntacyo bisobanuye cyane.
When you know the Lord is on our side.
Iyo uzi ko Uwiteka ari mu ruhande rwawe.
You are scared when men rise against you.
Ntuzatinye abantu baguhaguruka.
Because the Lord is not on your side.
Kubera ko Uwiteka yaba
atari mu ruhande rwawe. But when the Lord is on your side.
Ariko iyo Uwiteka ari mu ruhande
rwawe. You cannot be scared.
Ntabwo wagira ubwoba.
You know one thing. Even if there is anything coming against me on my side, there is God. When the enemies come, they find they are not alone. You are not alone. They are thinking you are alone. You are not going to make it. But it's a good thing to declare, if the Lord is on my side, whatever that rises against me, I shall be able to overcome it. Not because of my power, not because of my strength, it's because on my side there is the Lord. Now when the Lord is on your side, you say, God, we are together. So the responsibility is yours. In case there is anybody rising against me, Lord, take over the responsibility. And the Bible says that the waters would have overwhelmed us. We were to be swallowed alive. The water was to carry us. But thank God, the Lord was on our side. When the waters came, when the enemies came, the Lord was on our side. So the enemy thought, you are on. Oh, I'm alone. But I've got good news. When you have this relationship with God, when God is on your side, then don't be scared. Let nothing scare you. Because God is able, more than able, to handle that thing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The water was to, the waters would have swallowed the waters, then the waters, then the swollen waters would have gone over our soul. Verse 6 says, blessed is the Lord. Blessed be the Lord. Who has not given us as a prey to their teeth. The enemies have teeth. But God is on your side. The teeth are there. And today as I speak to you, I know there are some teeth which are working against you. There are things which have opened their mouth so that they can be able to crush you. But listen, don't be scared by the teeth of the enemy. The Lord is there. The Lord is on your side. Whatever which is working against you, maybe you look at your family. You see the traces of some teeth which have been trying to eat you, which have been trying to crush you. They have been trying to grind you. But I've come to say this. It is not only the teeth which you should see. See the Lord on your side. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord has been there. And the Lord is there. God has not given us as a prey to their teeth. God is not giving us up as a prey. God has not given us up as a prey to their teeth. They knew their teeth. I'm going to eat something. But I've come to declare the teeth should not scare you. Because God is not giving you up to them as a prey. And verse 7 says, our soul has escaped as apart from the snare of the fowler. The snare is broken and we have escaped. What a message. The snare is broken. Listen to me, the snare is broken. The snare is no longer a snare. It is not be a threat to you. God is telling in his word. The word of God is life. The word of God is powerful. This is what God is telling you today. The snare is broken. The snare is there. But the snare you see, it is powerless. It has no work. It cannot accomplish anything. Because the snare is broken. It is no longer a snare. Yours is only to escape. I want to say to you, you're escaping. Because God has done the work of handling the snare. The snare is broken. The snare is broken. So when we talk about God taking the responsibility, we are talking about God handling the snares. God breaking the snares. We have escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. The maker of heaven and earth. He has not stopped helping. He is still our help. The Lord God Almighty. The one who was there from the beginning. The one who will be there even to the end. He is an everlasting God. He is eternal God. He is the mighty God. The true and faithful God. The Bible says, our help is in the name of the Lord. Your help is not in any other person. Your help is in the name of the Lord. He is the maker of heaven and earth. He is the one who created everything which is there. It was created by this God. And so we thank God because the Creator is a helper. He's not just a creator. He has the capacity to help you. When you know God is on your side.
You
are assured there is help. Make sure that God is on your side. God should be on your side because there is help. I see what is recorded in the Bible in the book of Numbers. Numbers chapter 13. The Bible is talking about the children of Israel. That Numbers chapter 13 from verse
1.
The Bible says, and the Lord spoke to Moses saying, set men to spy out the land of Canaan, which I'm giving to the children of Israel, that each tribe of their fathers, you shall send a man, everyone a leader among them.
Tuma abantu batate igihugu cy'Kanani icyo mpa Abisirayeli. Ukuru umuntu mu muryango w'abasekuruza wose, umuntu wese ari umutware wabo.
God is speaking to Moses.
Imana iri kuvugana na Mose.
Now, you know, when God is taking responsibility,
that means Imana ari yifashe inshingano
zose. He won't be speaking.
Izagivuga.
Listen to God.
Wige kumva
Imana. Because when you hear God,
kubera ko yawumvise
Imana, the very first step
intambwe
ya mbere God to take responsibility
kugira ngo Imana ifate inshingano
is to have that relationship.
Nuko ufitanye isano.
Such that when God is speaking,
you
can hear. A lot of us, so many of us, we need to see God working. But before God works, make a point of hearing God. The Bible is saying that, and the Lord spoke to Moses. God is a God who speaks. He spoke to Moses. And when he spoke to Moses, he told him, send men to go and spy the land of Canaan. There is a land to be spied. But before sending the spy, there is hearing what God is saying. At a time like this, learn to hear what God says. Many of us, we need miracles. It is a good thing to go for miracles. But before miracle, hear the one who performs miracles. God Almighty, the performer of miracles. He does not only perform miracles, he also speaks. Listen to God. God told Moses, send the spy to the land of Canaan. That means that God's idea was before anything. Listen to me, Moses. God has an idea here. See the plan of God. See what God is planning. I want to give the children of Israel a land. The land is available. And before I give them the land, there should be the hearing of God. You need to hear God because God is speaking. And Moses was told, now this is the idea. The idea is from who? From God. God has an idea. Irrespective of what is happening in your life, God has an idea. God has an idea. Listen to me. What is happening right now, it is not the final thing. There is an idea from God. God, the Almighty God, he has an idea. That is why he is trying now to tell Moses, this is my idea. This is my plan. Moses.
Moses.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Moses.
Moses.
Send spies. Choose 12 leaders from every family. Send them to go and check on the land. And Moses did what God told him to do. Learn to do what God has told you to do. But you cannot do it until you hear him. So learn to hear God so that you can obey. You cannot obey if you can't hear. There is an element of hearing. I wish you can understand what I'm saying. I started by saying, create a relationship with God such that when God speaks, you hear. Have a relationship such that you can say, on my side, there is God. Now God speaks. And Moses obeys. This is what God is commanding. Send the spies to go and check on the land. We see verse 3 saying, So Moses sent them from the wilderness of Paran according to the command of the Lord. All of them men who were heads of the children of Israel.
Mose abatuma mu butayu bwa Parani uko witeka yategetse. Aba yatumye bose bari abatware b'Isiraeli.
We see obedience here.
Tubona hano harimo kuba.
Moses is obeying God.
Mose yubaha Imana.
And he has followed the command of God.
Arangije yubaha itegeko
ry'Uwiteka. God will give you a command.
Imana izaguha itegeko.
There is an instruction.
Hari amabwiriza.
There is an order.
Hari amategeko.
God has a command.
Imana
ifite. God is telling you.
Imana igiye kukubwira.
Which channel?
Izakubwira
umuntu. You can go to.
Ushobora
kugira. And when you go to that channel.
Kandi nunyara
muri. It is my channel.
Uza
numwe. When you go there. You'll be able to get what God has for you. So Moses received the command. He obeyed the command. And so the children of Israel were sent. We know they went and they spied the land. And the Bible says, if you go to verse number
25,
the Bible says, after spying the land, the spies, they came back. And they returned from spying out the land after 40 days. After 40 days, they are returning. After 40 days, they are coming back. They have seen the land. They have seen what is happening in the land. And these 40 days, they are time to go and confirm what God said. Is it true or is it not true? Now, after returning from spying the
rat,
they came with a report. And I want to say this. You need to prepare to come back with a report. These are Torah leaders. They are coming back with a report. Now the report they are bringing back, they came also with the fruit from the land. They said, yes, it is true. The land is flowing with milk and honey. And they also brought the fruit. But the fruit which they brought was not enough to change their testimony. Because you were the way you perceive God will not be changed by the fruits. It will be changed by the relationship. The way you relate with God determines how you will be able to perceive God. These people have come back. They have a fruit. But they said, even if the land is flowing with milk and honey, even if we have carried the fruit, still we have carried bad news. Now this is a problem. Somebody carrying blessing and he is also carrying unbelief. He is carrying negative news. These are the days of negative news. But relate with God such that the news you have are not negative. Relate with God such that when you are talking, you are not talking of unbelief. We see in verse 27, the Bible says, in verse number 27, then they told him, and he said, we went to the land where you sent us. It truly flows with milk and honey. And this is its fruit. Verse 28 says, nevertheless, the people who dwell in the land are strong. Now, what is happening here? They have fruit. But fruit is not changing. Because God would want you to have a relationship. Not only a fruit. A fruit. You know, you can have a fruit. But that does not change your concept of God. The way you look at God. They are carrying the fruit. But they are saying, nevertheless, the people who dwell in the land are strong.
abantu bagituyemo ni abanyamaboko.
The cities are fortified and very large.
Kandi imidugudu yabo igoteshejwe inkike.
Moreover, we saw the descendants of Anak there.
Ndetse twabonyeyo Abanaki.
Now, there, where they have come back,
bagarutse,
they are talking of what they have seen.
Baza baje kuvuga ibyo babonye.
Even if they have a fruit,
nubwo bafite,
when they saw,
ibyo babonye,
it is greater than the fruit.
Biraruta imbuto bazanye.
Because they are talking about the descendants of Anak. They are saying, even if we were sent by God, what we saw
is
more magnified than what God said. Now, we need to handle one thing. For you to give God this responsibility, you need to think about God as God. Not walking by what you see. Not walking by what is happening. The Bible says we don't walk by sight. But our walk is a walk of faith. Now when you walk by faith, the Bible says that the just shall live by faith. Now this time, these people, what they see, it is the sons of Anak, the descendants of Anak. And my friend, wherever you are, could be the descendants of Anak, which are taking away what God promised you, which is making you even to not to breathe what God said concerning you. Today is the day we want to deal with the descendants of Anak, because the Bible says they said they are descendants of Anak. The land is good, nevertheless they are descendants of Anak there. These are big people. They are giants. Now, they were scared because of what they saw. Don't be scared because of what you see. What God has said concerning you is greater than what you see. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God's will is always the best. That is, God's will is will always be the best. But it's not enough to know the will of God in our heads. Listen to me. It is not enough to know the will of God in our heads. You need to step out and you experience the will of God in your life. The will of God will help you when you apply it in your life. When you know it in your head, it will be theory. But you have to take a step and move with the will of God. What I see these people, they are 12 of them, and 10 are giving negative testimony. But I see two people who knew, if you have given God our responsibility, He will be able to take over. And Him as God, He is going to do what He is able to do. I see Joshua and Caleb. That's the time when others are talking negative. Joshua and Caleb, they are talking different. Look at verse 30. The Bible says, verse 30, then Caleb quieted the people before Moses and said, let us go up at once and take possession, for we are well able to overcome it.
Caleb ahoreza abantu imbere ya Mose ati, tuzamuke nonaha tuhahindure.
You need to be a Caleb who can say, even if others who are majority are talking differently. Me, I don't want to talk like majority. It's not democracy here. It is hearing God. Caleb says, my relationship with God is greater than what others are saying. Others are saying we can't make it. Others are talking of the chance they saw. But Caleb, he decided, because I have a relationship, I'm going to silence everybody. Have a relationship with God such that you can silence the others. It's like Elijah when he's saying to King Ahab, let us meet at Mount Carmel. If any bow has so many prophets, but one thing I know, I may be the only one, but because of the relationship, I am going to overcome. Listen to me. Caleb says, we are well able. Listen to me. You are well able. But it do not just just be an imagination. It's alive. It's alive. You live such that whatever happens, you know, I'm well able. Because of God. When God takes the responsibility, He makes things happen in His own way. The other 10 are talking different. They are talking defeat. Don't defeat. From today, say with me, I will not talk defeat. I will not talk defeat. Repeat this. From this day, I'm going to be the Caleb. I'm going to be the Joshua. I know the others. They have the number. But us, we have the relationship. The others are talking because of what they saw. But Joshua and Caleb, they are talking because of God they know. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They said, we are well able. Let us go up at once. Listen to me. That is going up. Don't go down. Caleb says, let us go up. Things are making you to go under. Things are making you to go down. But Caleb says, at once, let us go up. At once, let us go up at once. Because there is a land to possess. We are taking our possession. The possession is not for people who are going down. It's for the people who are saying, let us go up at once. Can't you be a Caleb today who can talk different from the other people? The other people are saying it's not possible. But Caleb says, let us go up. Let us go up. I'm calling on you. Listen to me. Wherever you are, I'm calling on you. That is, I'm going up at once. I know the situations are taking you down. The conditions are putting you down. But listen, the voice of Caleb was, let us go up. At once, for we are well able to take the position. We are well able to take that which God has prepared for us. Stop going low. Stop going down. Don't go down again. And it's a good thing to declare we are moving from this position to another position. Now, you know, when they saw the sons of Anak, they say, when we were before these people, that's not the one. Very important. But the man who had gone up with him said, we are not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we. They are stronger. How comes they are stronger? It's because you have already brainwashed. You don't see the greatness of your God. You don't see that God who told you. It's God who brought the idea. It's not Moses. It was God's idea. So listen, don't see greater people. Don't see stronger people. See God who is mighty.
Maze abantu bari bajyanye nawe baravuga bati ntitwabasha kuzamuka ngo turwanye abo bantu kuko tubarusha amaboko. Kubera icyo bavuga ngo nuko baturusha amaboko, nukubera yuko bo ntago bari kubona Imana mu ruhande rwabo. Nta igitekerezo ntago cyaturutse kuri Mose, cyaturutse ku Imana. Imana rero niyo izabarwanirira.
A bad report was given in verse 32. They gave the children of Israel a bad report of the land which they had spied out. They said the land through which we and God as spies is a land that defies its inhabitants, and all the people whom we saw in it are men of great stature.
Baravuga bati igihugu twanyuzemo tugitata ni igihugu cy'umwibyane kandi abantu twakibonyemo bose ni barebare.
There we saw the giants, the descendants of Anak came from the giants, and we were like grasshoppers in our sight, and so we were in their sight.
Kandi twabonyemo abantu barebare banini, abanaki bakomotse ku bantu barebare banini, twibonaga tumeze nk'inzige nabo bakabona tumeze nkazo.
In the year 2020,
umwaka wa 2020,
I refuse grasshopper mentality.
Nanze kugira ibitekerezo
nk'inzige. I will not talk like a grasshopper. I am a son of God. I want to command in Jesus' name. You are not a grasshopper. Your name is not a grasshopper. You are called by the name of the Lord. God knows you. God is caring about you. You tell me there is a virus. That is also God. You tell me there is a pandemic. That is also God. He is God. Exalted above this virus. In the sea and declare. I know people are saying, we are coming to the middle of the year and things are not working. Things are not working. But God is working. Let God take the responsibility. This year, I refuse to be like a grasshopper. I'm not a grasshopper. Listen to me. You're not a grasshopper. Why are you talking like a grasshopper? You think like a grasshopper? You look at yourself like a grasshopper. You are not a grasshopper. You are son of God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In their sight, they saw themselves like in grasshoppers, and the way they saw themselves is the way they were seen. Listen to me from today. Let devils, let demons, if Satan is himself, let him know there is a child of God. You are not a grasshopper. I refuse to be a grasshopper. I refuse that mentality, that mindset of a grasshopper. I'm changing my side today. Change your side today. Irrespective of what has happened. In your family, you're not a grasshopper. In your place of work, you're not a grasshopper. In your business, you're not a grasshopper. He said to me, I know business are crossing down. But your source is God. You're not a grasshopper. And because you are son of God, that God is going to give you victory. You need to stand and say, I'm not a grasshopper. I'm not going to accept that mindset of grasshopper. My children are blessed by them. Talk things to your children. Start declaring to them, my children, you are not grasshopper. Talk to your business today. Speak to that business. Tell that business, you are not a grasshopper. Talk to your wife. I know you've been telling her, this is nothing. From today, turn to a terror. You are not a grasshopper. Turn to your husband. Is not a grasshopper. Grasshopper mentality. We want to stop it now. In the name of Jesus. That mentality of grasshopper, I refuse it now. I stop it now. Stand with me. Declare from today, no grasshopper mentality. The spirit of grasshopper, I break it now. In the name of Jesus. You are not a grasshopper. You are not. The devil is trying to make you to be so much intimidated.
Satana ashaka kugukoza
isoni. When you look at yourself, you see I am a grasshopper. Change your mentality. You are not a grasshopper. You are not a grasshopper. I'm leaving the position. Hallelujah. Of grasshoppers. Leave that position. Leave that place of grasshoppers. Leave that position of a grasshopper. Go to another position of a child of God. Today as I pray with you, we are declaring transfer from grasshopper position to the position of a child of the living God.
bana w'Imana.
I declare to you today.
Ndatura ngo uyu munsi.
Even if you tell me, I don't always going to help me. Let me think God such that the help from God will be manifested in your life. Be so much related, so much connected, so much with God such that you are the one who will be able to say, the Lord is on my side. We thank God. Because from today, can you declare with me, wherever you are, as you watch us, even as you listen to us, this is so much from God Almighty that God is telling us today, we are coming from that position of grasshopping. You are not going to hope again. You are not going to be a grasshopper. You know, grasshopper, jumping. There is no proper planning. You are there, you are nowhere. But now, let me be God, such that whenever we want to see you, we will see you in one place, in the plan of God.
Imana imavuga ngo mu mugambi wayo ntago ugiye kuba inzige, inzige ihora igenda isimbuka nta gahunda ifite, ariko irashaka yuko uhagarara mu mwanya nyawo mu mugambi w'Imana.
May the Lord bless you.
Imana ibahe umugisha.
May the Lord keep you.
Imana ibayobore.
May the Lord manifest himself upon your life.
Imana yigaragaze
ku buzima. And from this day,
kandi kuva uyu munsi,
you are changing.
Urahindutse.
You are not a grasshopper.
Ntago uri inzige.
In the name of Jesus.
Mu izina rya Yesu.
Father, I declare
that and that to you.
In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Mu izina rya Yesu Kristo.
From this day,
kuva uyu munsi,
there is a divine transfer from being grasshoppers to being the children of the Most High God. You, Father, you are not the Father of grasshoppers. You are not God, the Father who runs away from responsibilities. But from this day, we are letting you now to take the responsibilities. We thank you, Lord. We bless you. I pray for them those who are sick in their bodies. Now, in the name of Jesus, let the healing flow in your body. In the name of Jesus, any other disaster which is working against you, we stop it now. In Jesus' name, may God bless you. Amen.
Dushimye Imana ku bw'ijambo, Pastor wakoze cyane kutubwiriza ijambo ryiza nk'iri ngiri. Iki ni igihe nyacyo cyo kudatinya, cyo kutaba inzige, cyo kutibona nk'inzige, ahubwo tugahagarara dushikamye kubera ko Imana iri mu ruhande rwacu. Uwiteka ari mu ruhande rwacu, nta mubisha n'umwe wadutera. Reka dushimire abantu bose badufashije, President Worship Team Imana ibahe umugisha, Pastor Imana ibahe umugisha, abakoze ku buhanga bw'ibyuma Imana ibahe umugisha, tuzongera duhure mu materaniro nk'aya ngaya. Mana tuguhaye icyubahiro kubw'ibyo wakoze, Mana turagushimye kubw'ijambo ryawe. Reka ryera imbuto mu buzima bwacu, rigira icyo rihindura mu buzima bwacu, abibonaga nk'inzige ubuzima buhinduke, tube bashya muri wowe, kandi dutangire kuvuga nk'abatsinzi kurushaho. Tuguhaye icyubahiro kubw'ibyo ugiye gukora, nyuma y'iri jambo tugiye kubona imbuto nshya, tugiye kubona abantu batandukanye, tugiye kubona abantu bafitanye isano nawe irusha iyo bari bafite. Mu izina rya Yesu Kristo, amina.